Hello and thanks for watching Proactive. Technology Minerals says its 49% owned battery recycling business Recyclus has received three lithium battery testbed systems at its Wolverhampton site. Joining with more is the company's executive chairman, Robin Brundle. Robin, good to speak with you again.
Good afternoon to you. How are you?
Good, thank you, Robin. So tell us about those battery testing systems and what they can do.
Yeah, sure. Well, they're actually a very important part of our future plans. These machines are akin to what global OEMs would have, for example. So very powerful machines. They're designed to test automotive battery packs as they come onto our premises in Wolverhampton. And part of the strategy for the circular economy is not just recycling, it's actually about reusing as well. So as these packs will arrive through the factory gates, they'll be tested via these machines and then be able to be recertified. Those that pass the test, of course, will be able to be recertified to go back out again for things like energy storage, for example. So it's really important for us to be able to do that and give those batteries a second life. But equally as well, for us, we're able then to, as the various batteries come in through the gate again, in some of them will have charge in the batteries. So we're able to extract that charge and put it into the machine. And we then have the option to either put that back into the grid and sell it back into the grid rather than wasting it effectively. As we will expect to do, perhaps in about 12 months' time, have our own energy storage systems on the site so that we can top up our own energy storage for light machinery and any visiting electric vehicles that can then take the charge from our storage system. So it's a big milestone for us. These machines are pretty rare around the world. It's taken nearly 11 months to arrive. So for us, it's quite a big moment and still work to do to get it up and commissioned, of course, as always with any new plant. But yeah, so we're very excited, as our finance team would say, about a shiny new box, but it does a lot of work.
Can you take us through how the batteries are graded and tested and how they could be repurposed for other applications?
Yeah, sure. So these battery cells will be predominantly automotive rather than mobile phones or e-bikes. It could be train batteries as well, you know, lithium ion batteries off of trains that are big, heavy duty batteries. There's an option to retest them, and providing they're around 80% viable compared to their original specification, then we're able to recertify them to go back out to have this second life. But as a general rule, anything that's less than 80% will then have to go through and go through our shredding process and be recycled to get the ingredients back again.
Robin, you mentioned the future possibility to feed energy back into the national grid. Can you tell us a bit more about that?
Yeah, sure. So it really is quite simple. So that the machine extracts the energy, and we have the ability to literally put a nice thick cable into back into the grid with a monitor on it and a meter on it, of course. So it's all done very safely and recorded. So we can then have a deal with our local provider. We have a substation on the corner of our Wolverhampton site. So the intention there is working with that energy provider is to have a deal to put electricity back into the grid, for the benefit of all, really.
With the move to electrification, there's going to be a need for capacity to reuse and recycle end-of-life batteries. How is Technology Minerals part of that solution, Robin?
We are recycling through our company called Recyclus Group. So we're recycling lead acid batteries. We're also recycling separately in a different process, the lithium ion batteries. And we are early to market with this, as we've perhaps told some of the listeners before. We're in a state of readiness to go, just waiting for a variation of license progressing very nicely. On the lead acid side, we had another visit today, funnily enough, for our battery trading operators license, which is now we expect to be imminent. So all of our listeners that have been waiting to expect some revenue, we're fingers crossed for those licenses to be in place on the lead acid side through July. We've also been designing, as we've said before, the battery boxes for the safe transportation of the lithium-ion batteries. We've passed the fire test with that box, and we're just waiting next week for the drop test. But of course, we've done all of our own drop tests and so on. So we're actually committing to manufacturing. And again, there should be revenue from those boxes as we go through July. So all looking pretty strong at the moment. Sadly, it's the bureaucracy of the permits, which, again, we've mentioned before, that's just holding us back. But the sites are looking good. The employees are in place. The ISO systems are there. And, you know, we're expecting from the lead side and also from the boxes, fingers crossed, to get some revenue coming through for July. Lithium ion side, we are, again, you know, we've mentioned that the Recyclus group has been given a status, my wording, of national importance, if you like, to the infrastructure of the UK. So that gives us a chance to escalate the permits through the lithium ion side. And, you know, we are literally just waiting for that process to complete. And again, you know, we've got a whole range of global operators wanting to come and have a look at the process as soon as we're able to fully switch it on.
I mean, there's clearly plenty going on to keep you busy. Can you give us a general update on progress in business?
It's pretty much as I've just described, actually. And, you know, it's very exciting space to be in right now. It's the first UK capability for the lithium ion. And it's great to be able to industrialize the lead side as well. So we take the human element out of people hand sawing and have the dangers of acid and lead and so on by being so close and from the contamination. So we take that away with our industrialized program on the lead and on scale as well, you know. And excitingly, you know, we're close to getting sites number 3 and number 4 ready for next year. And especially keen to get those running. When I say running, get those in progress, because we know that there's going to be lengths of time to get these licenses through from the environmental agency. So we're cracking on. So yes, a lot going on. There's a lot of good news flow to come from us. And you can tell by how upbeat we are that, you know, it's definitely right place, right time for us.
Well, I hope you'll keep us updated on any of the progress, but thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thank you for your time.
That's Robin Brundle. He's Executive Chairman at Technology Minerals.